This is the HSO3- Lewis structure. When we see the H out in front, we know that it's going to be attached to the outside of one of these oxygens when we draw the Lewis structure. We'll put the sulfur in the middle, it's the least electronegative, oxygens around it, three of them, and then that hydrogen we said would go on the outside of one of the oxygens. For the HSO3- Lewis structure, we have a total of 26 valence electrons. We'll put two between atoms to form chemical bonds. We've used eight, and then around the oxygens to fill their octets, 10, 12, and 24. So we've used 24, we have 26. We'll put the last two on the central atom, the sulfur, and we've used all the valence electrons. At this point, the sulfur has eight valence electrons. The oxygens each have eight, so their octets are full. Hydrogen has two, so its outer shell is full as well. So this looks like a pretty good structure. However, when you look at the periodic table, sulfur is in period 3. That means it can hold more than 8 valence electrons. So we really want to look at the formal charges here. When we calculate the formal charges, we see that the sulfur has a plus 1, and then these oxygens each here have a minus 1. We'd like our formal charges to be as close to 0 as possible. So what we can do is take two valence electrons here and share them in the center to form a double bond. When we do that, the formal charge on the oxygen changes to 0 and the sulfur goes to 0. So now we have a negative 1 here, but we're going to leave that because it is a negative ion. So that makes this the most stable Lewis structure for HSO3-, and since it is an ion, we'll need to put brackets around it and a negative charge. So that's the Lewis structure for HSO3-. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.